Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about why we only do apps. So last week I was having a conversation with a business owner about the future of my company. We're talking about long-term goals, right? So his company was about the same size as mine, and we were sort of comparing notes, like, and we're talking about our goals for like 3 to 5 years, which is something I'm getting more open about admitting to people rather than just trying to do it on my own and hoping that I do, and then I'll tell everybody what that goal was. So I was talking to him about it, and one of my long-term goals, or like a three-year goal, was to expand the offerings of Overpass to also do like SharePoint and Salesforce or whatever the big CRM systems are at the time, the enterprise stuff, right? Which is stuff that I've worked with before. I'm not a big fan of SharePoint, but I've worked with those kind of systems before. And the other person, he was asking me, he was saying, why don't you just offer that stuff now? I mean, if you can already do it now, why don't you just offer it now? And my whole thing was that we're focusing on apps. Apps is what we do. That's the one thing. I want to get, so we're so good at doing apps that they don't want to, there's no reason to go anywhere else, right? So my whole reason behind thinking this and thinking about niches in general is I think about Walmart, right? So when I was living in Hawaii, I was big into to biathlons and stuff. Not triathlons, because I'm a terrible swimmer, but I was doing a few biathlons. I ran a marathon, I ran a bunch of half marathons, a bunch of 10Ks. Well, a couple half marathons, a bunch of 10Ks. Right, and there was this one shop called Island Triathlon and Bike. This was in Hawaii, right? And it was IT and B, I guess. So, and Island Triathlon and Bike was kind of like an expensive shop, but you get like really good bike stuff there. So if you're gonna get anything for your bike, you would go there because it was like really professional stuff, right? For the true athletes. Now the thing about this was you could also get bike stuff at Walmart, obviously. I guess it was Kmart in Hawaii at the time. Right, but you could also get bike stuff at Kmart, but you knew that if you went to Kmart, the quality wouldn't be as good, because Kmart was much more convenient, right? You could go there, you could get a bike, you could get a toilet brush, you could get cabbage, whatever you need to get. It's convenient, one-stop shop. But if you were going for quality, you would go to Island Triathlon and Bike, right? And this is the same with a lot of other things. There's certain services where you know, because they specialize in one thing, that they're better at that one thing. And this is something that we've been trying to do a lot with. Well, ever since we started doing apps, I stopped doing everything else. People say, why don't you say websites? Why don't you advertise for websites or PHP or all the other things that, especially when I was just coding myself, all the things I could do, right? I was just saying, no, just apps. And sometimes people call up and say, do you do websites? And I say, yeah, we could, but I prefer not to. We're an app development company, right? And it all goes back to that way of thinking about being a specialist. If someone's looking for quality, they're going to be looking for a specialist. Yeah, yesterday or a couple days ago, I was talking to you about how you when you do a CV, if you're looking for high paying jobs, my CV was really tight. Right, a CV is different than a corporate offering or like a company offering. So like my CV would have lots of skills that I've had over the years, which increased my value to a potential employer because I'd be sitting in their office doing all that kind of stuff. So that was important. Now if somebody's hiring me to provide them with the service for apps, and if I tell them, oh, we can also do WordPress design, or we can also do SharePoint development, that gives more of a, it gives the impression that I'm a generalist, and I have no intention of being a generalist when it comes to this business. Now, I think I read something once, I think it was a couple years ago, I think it was Seth Godin who said it, that when Google started out, the conventional wisdom at the time was like Yahoo and other portal websites was, you take a website, you put as much as you can on that front page, as much information as you can, and you have the search bar, and you just fill it with as much, advertising and everything like this. But Google went specialized. They were specialized in search. So they went the other way, and they had a text box and two buttons, you know, search and I feel lucky. Has anybody ever clicked on I feel lucky? I mean, I maybe tried it once or twice, but I never really found the use of it. I mean, who'd ever want to do that? Is that still there? I haven't even looked at it in a while. But Google became the specialist. If you talked about search, you would, like, if you were telling somebody to go and search for something, you wouldn't say, go check out Ask Jeeves. After a while, you'd say, go to Google, because it was, you knew that they were specialists in search, and because everything they did showed that they were specialists. Every day, or sometimes, you know, more than once a day, I get emails from companies in India or all over the place, and they're basically selling themselves as Walmart. They're saying, we do mobile applications, and then we also do all this other stuff. They'll say, we are specialists in PHP, SharePoint, C#, enterprise systems, and usually mobile applications is down at the bottom of the list. I don't know why they're emailing me, right? So they'll do all that kind of stuff, and what they're selling to me is, or at least the perception that I have of them, is that they are not specialists. Now, it is possible that they have the best mobile developer I've ever worked with working at that company, but they're not marketing that way. They don't give me, I don't get that impression with looking at it, and it's not worth my time to investigate any further. The same way that Kmart may have had a better bike than Island Triathlon and Bike back in the day, right? But it wasn't worth the trip, and it was, even if I had bought the best bike ever from Kmart, there'd be this doubt in the back of my head that, did I go the right way? Should I have gone to the other place? And that is what we try to do when we specialize in apps. One day we'll offer more stuff. When we start getting a decent sized client base, when our client base starts to grow, then maybe we'll branch out a little bit. We probably won't still do the same brands, you know, or the same branding. We'll probably set up a separate website, a separate entity to handle all that kind of stuff. But right now, I'm completely and totally focused on apps, you know, for those reasons. I believe in niches, and it's the same with applications too, right? When you're marketing your app, you can go general and generic and try to cast the net wide, or you can go specific and be really optimized for search, right? And that's, you know, one thing that we find. This is one of the reasons why we do language learning games. This is one of the reasons why I had such big problems with Apple's 4.3 rules a few months ago, was because I don't want to cast the net wide. I want to cast the net specifically, looking for specific people who are looking specifically to learn that one specific language. So anyway, I hope that makes sense today. That's it for today. Hasta mañana.